السلام عليكم
ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على السلام
ونستجيره من النار ونتوب إليه من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا نحمده حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه حمدا يليق بجلالته وعظمته ونصلي ونسلم على محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين إخوة الإيمان أوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل فإن تقوى الله من وصيته سبحانه وتعالى علينا وعلى الأمم السابقة قال تعالى ولقد وصينا الذين من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله فاتقوا الله ما استطعتم واتقوه تفلحوا وفي هذه الأيام المباركات حيث يستودع كثيرا من الناس أهلهم وأصدقائهم مستعدين للسفر الذي هو ركن من أركان الإسلام ويوجهون إلى بيت الله العتيق ليؤدوا فريضة الحج فعليهم وعلينا حقوق سنذكر بعدها إن شاء الله تعالى ونسأل الله أن يوفقنا وإياكم لما فيه خير لديننا ولدنيانا قال تعالى الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج وما تفعل من خير يعلمه الله وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقون يا أولي الألباب. Brothers in Islam, brothers and sisters in Islam, we say many thanks and praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always for making us Muslims. Whether you are young, whether you are a bit older, whether you are a man or a woman, whether you are poor or rich, you are healthy or ill, anytime you find yourself a Muslim, you say Alhamdulillah. Because it is the only thing that's of value and treasure, both here and hereafter. So when you find yourself a Muslim, even though things may be hard, the going may be tough, but you always say Alhamdulillah. Now what would you think? مَا ذَنُّكَ بِقَوْلِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. What do you think of what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says when he wonders? The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wonders not because of wealth or wealthy people. He wonders at the affairs of the mu'min, the believers. The Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam is wondering about the iman that believers have, that their hearts have become receptacle of the deen and the faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does he say? He said, ajaban li amri mu'min. So he wonders at the affairs of the believers. فَإِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلُّهُ لَهُ خَيْرٌ. All the affairs of a believer, a Muslim believer, a female believer, a male believer, a young believer, an old believer, as long as you are a believer, you believe in the six articles of Iman. تُ�مِنَ بِاللَّهِ, you believe in Allah. وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ, you believe in his angel. وَكُتُبِهِ, you believe in his book. You believe in the qadr, the good and the bad. You believe in Yawm al-Akhir. And you believe in all the prophets. According to the deen in Islam, then you are a believer. You are mu'min. And the Rasul is wondering at your affairs because everything for you khair is good. How? And we live in two states. Either it's good or it's bad. So he says, إِذَا أَسَابَهُ خَيْرٌ. When you have good things, what does he do? It's Alhamdulillah. So when a Muslim succeeds in his project, when a Muslim gets a good job, when a Muslim passes their exam, when a Muslim marries a Muslim woman, or a Muslim sister is married to a Muslim man, he says Alhamdulillah. But what about when the opposite happens? When asabahu sarra, when something afflicts him, sadness, grief, bereavement, loss of property, loss of life, what does he do? Sabr. He is patient and then he thank Allah and he says Alhamdulillah. So that's the condition, that's the status of a mu'min, a believer. Somebody who is not shaken by world events, somebody who is not shaken by the trials and tribulations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring to them once in a while. They stand very firm in their deen. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He indeed has created man in hardship. وَلَكَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has really created us in that fashion. So you can't be laughing all the time, and so you cannot be crying all the time. But once your iman is firm, strong, qawi, then you are fine. And so the Rasulullah says in the other hadith, Al-mu'min al-qawi, the believer that's strong, khair, it's good, wa ahab, and is more beloved to Allah, min al-mu'min al-da'if, from the believer that's weak. But in both of these people, the weak believer and the strong believer, khair, kulli minhum khair. Okay? The hadith continues, Ihris ala ma yanfa'uk. Focus, concentrate, put your time, your energy into what brings benefit to you. If it doesn't bring benefit to you, cut it off. If it doesn't bring benefit to you, leave it, my friend. Leave it, my brothers, because it's a waste of time. Allah said, but Rasulullah said, فَلَا تَعْجَزْ, do not despair. So why don't you focus on things that will be beneficial to your life, to your family, to your community, to your deen, then do not despair, even if you are walking and the tides are against you. Even if you're walking and you feel like a mountain is there for you to climb. So may Allah make it easy for us. May Allah give us strong iman. So today we're going to run quickly because Qulna, we said Yastawdiu kathiran min al-nas min al-muslimin. Many Muslims now are saying goodbyes. لماذا? Why? لأنهم يستعدون, because they are preparing لأداء مناسك الحج, to go and perform the Hajj rites. So they're saying goodbyes. Some people have already gone, some people are going, some people will be going this week. So they have rights and we have rights too. They have rights and we have rights too. They have responsibilities and we have responsibilities too. See? Only it is deen that makes us believers and then gives us duties and responsibilities. Why are they going for Hajj? Because Hajj is the fifth pillar of Islam. Fi hadith Ibn Umar qala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it says Bunya al-Islam al-Khams, that Islam is built upon five pillars. And amongst them, or the last one, is Hajj al-Bayt liman istata'a ilayhi sabila. To go for Hajj for those who can afford it. So two conditions of Hajj: physical ability and financial stability. So you should financially and physically be able to afford to go for Hajj. But ladain, don't take debt to go for Hajj. Latakhudh daynan. In kana alayka dayn, and if you have debt, then you have to pay the people that you owe, or you negotiate with them. Then la tahujj bimalin haram, do not go to Hajj with haram money, because going to Hajj with haram money does not make it halal.
Like people will say, if I play the lotto or the lottery and I win £2 million, I go and build masjid. The basis of your wealth is haram. So it doesn't go to the mizan of your hasanat. It doesn't go to the scale. Because people play jokes with Allah. Inna Allah tayyib, la yaqbalu illa tayyib. Allah is pure and He doesn't accept anything but things that are pure. So the Arab poet says, إِذَا حَجَّجْتَ بِمَالٍ حَرَامٍ فَإِنَّكَ لَمْ تَحُجْ وَلَكِنَّ الْإِيرَ حَجَّتْ. If you go to Hajj with haram money, with haram source of wealth, you did not go for Hajj. It is the camel and the cattle that went for Hajj. You did not go. So you make sure that your source of income is halal. But don't play tricks, because this is what people do. Check. They come and ask us surface questions. I cannot know everything. Sheikh Abdul Salam cannot know everything. They don't know the secret. Sheikh Shuaib does not know the secret. Sheikh Yusuf and Misbah and Bailo and all of them. They don't know. You know and Allah knows. So make sure your source of income is pure. It is your labor or somebody else's labor that is pure. Because you are doing manasik. And this manasik, or this mansak that you are doing, this right that you are doing, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts it, then you are coming back kayoma waladatka ummu. You are coming back like the day you were born. Sinless. So let us not take the ibadah as a joke. Why should you not take it as a joke? Because you don't know whether it's going to be akhiru waqt, akhiru fursa. It's the last opportunity for you. You're not going to have another opportunity again. So why do you waste the one that you already have? Many people have gone to Hajj once in their life. They could never go back again. Some because of health, some people passed away. Some that they could not even afford it again. But what do they need to do? Apart from these ones I have itemized, before they go, قَبْلَ أَنْ تَمْشِي قَبْلَ أَنْ تَذْهَبِ إِلَى الْحَجِّ أُطْلُبْ الْعَفْوَ. Seek forgiveness from the people that you have known and the people you have dealt with. Do not go to Hajj and you're carrying grudge. Do not go to Hajj and you have this big baggage of worries, of dhulm, oppression. You're going to Hajj to come as a changed person. So ask forgiveness from those that you have offended and from those that have offended you. Do not be arrogant and proud. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من تودى لله رفعه. When you humble yourself for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will lift you up. He will raise you up. So go to your brother, go to your sister and say, if I have offended you, please forgive me. And you offended me this time and this time, I have forgiven you. And this is the dua that we say during Laylatul Qadr that Aisha told us. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. Oh Allah, you are you love mercy, you are merciful. You are forgiven. You pardon. Although people draw technicalities between the two languages, but it doesn't matter. Allah forgives. So you're asking Allah to forgive you. But when you go to Hajj, you're going to ask Allah to forgive you for all your sins, all your shortcomings. Why not ask your brother or your sister to forgive you? Why are you proud, Akhi? And then, you do what they call redul madhalim. If you have taken somebody else's money, somebody else's wealth, somebody else's property, by illegal means, then you give it back. You give it back. Because if you don't give it fi dunya, you give it in akhirah. That's how simple it is. And yawm al-qiyamah, you don't have money. You don't have money to pay. You pay with your salah, with your zakat, with your hajj, with your umrah, with your dhikr. That's what you take to pay back. And that's why the real poverty is. And that's why the Rasulullah says to the Sahaba, Ataduruna man muflis? Do you know who is poor? They say somebody, laysa lahu malun, laysa lahu dirham wala dinar. Somebody who does not have dirham and dinars. These were currencies of the past. He says no. It's somebody who comes yawm al-qiyamah wakad zalama hadha, wakad daraba hadha, wakad shatama hadha. This person has slapped this person, has oppressed this person, has backbitten this person. And yawm al-qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says you have to pay this person. And you don't have something to pay. And they take from your hasanat and they give to them. وَإِذَنْتَعَتِ الْحَسَنَاتِ When your hasanat is finished, when your good deeds are done, then the malaika will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَاذَا نَفْعَلْ What do we do? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, take from the person who they offend, take from their own evil, their own sayyi'at, their own evil deeds, and give it to them. So you see how poor some people are going to be yawm al-qiyamah. So do not be like the people who saw Karun. Karun was the wealthiest man in the time of Musa alayhi salam. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed Karun, those who were saying, wow, we wish we could become Karun, they said, no. So some people you see riding in Mercedes, they're riding in this, they're riding in that, they're coming yawm al-qiyamah, they are muflis. And if your scale is not heavy, yawm al-qiyamah on the good side. That's it. Because that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Qariyah. فَمَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَهُوَ فِي عَيْشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ Whosoever scale is heavy on the right side, then they live in blissful accommodation. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٍ And those whose scales are light on the good side, that means their scales are heavy on the bad. فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ That lodging place is going to be hawiya. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ What is hawiya? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, two words. نَارٌ حَامِيَةٌ Fire. It's going to be burning there. Hot. Surah Al-Qariyah. So when you see people decorated in this dunya, akhi, do not be fooled and do not live in that delusion. Ihris ala ma yanfa'uk. Focus on what will benefit you. So, ask for forgiveness. Go to Hajj when you have the opportunity. Do not delay. Do not delay at all. People have been spending money sending other people to Hajj and they're not going. Thinking, oh, I am too young to go to Hajj. And a man raised a child in the time of the Rasulullah SAW. He says, Ali had a Hajj. Does this child has Hajj? Then the Rasulullah SAW says, yes. Walaka Hajj. And you have the reward. But when they grow up, they have to go Hajjul Islam. They have to go their own Hajj. But children can go to Hajj. So Ataibu min adhamin kamala adhamba la akum akal istagfiru rabbakum innahu kana ghafura. Alhamdulillah. I say many thanks and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the first khutbah,
we mentioned about our people istaiduna lil hajj. They're going, preparing to go for hajj. And we said they have duties and responsibilities, and we mentioned some of them. Awwal, we said, when you have the opportunity, the ability, financial as well as physical, when you're well in body as well as in your pocket, then you have to go to hajj. Doesn't matter whether you're a man or a woman. Then you have to ask forgiveness from your brothers and your sisters, and you have to forgive those who have offended you. Then you have to make sure that the source of your income, what you buy your ticket with, what you buy your packages with, is halal. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah tayyib. Allah is clean, is pure. La yakbalu illa tayyiba. He doesn't accept anything except things that are pure. And the Arab says, إِذَا حَجَّجْتَ بِمَالٍ حَرَامٍ فَإِنَّكَ لَمْ تَحُجْ وَلَكِنَّ الْإِيرَ حَجَّتْ. If you go to hajj with money, resources that's haram, then you did not go to hajj. Now, what about us who are not going to hajj? Firstly, is to forgive our brothers and our sisters when they ask us for forgiveness. Whatever the crime, whatever the sin, whatever the misunderstanding, find a space in your heart and forgive them. Then you pray for them. Because when you pray for them, the prayer is sent back to you. And then for those who can afford it, you give them something. You give them a gift to go with. Sometimes you give them money to help them on the way. And then you also find time to look after their families when they are there. Sometimes it's just a phone call. Sometimes it's just to check on them. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our brothers and our sisters who have not been to hajj to have the courage to go to hajj. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make people who are afraid of the crowd, who have crowd phobia, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure that phobia for them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all our brothers and our sisters all over the world who are going for hajj, may Allah protect them this year. Last year we had zero incident in Mecca because they've changed the way we go to the Jamarat. The crowd does not mix, and it's a lot of walking, but it's a very good exercise. So there's improvement all the time. So you don't need to be scared that when you go there, you die. But if you go there, you die. Say, Alhamdulillah, because we're all going to die. It's better you die in Mecca, they bury you there, where Dajjal is not going to go, rather than you stay here in this kubur that Dajjal is going to come and make waswasa on you. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy. Amen. So do our brothers who are going and our sisters who are going, finally, hajj is challenging. You're going to be meeting up with different nationalities, different people. So, alayka bi sabr. You need to be patient. And as sakina, like the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the sahabas when they were coming from Arafat and they were going to Muzdalifah. Say, as sakina, as sakina. So you go peacefully and quietly. Because the ajr that you get there is so wonderful. And you come with a lot of blessings. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for them. We can't say everything. Some of them have taken a lot of classes and stuff. But please, let's pray for them. And we who are going to be left here, inshallah, before the day of Arafah comes, forgives the sin of a whole year. So when the day of Arafah comes, please make sure you find out about the day of Arafah. And for the brothers and the sisters who are on WhatsApp and who are on Facebook, instead of you sending bad videos, please make sure you circulate the day of Arafah, so that a lot of the brothers encourage them to keep fast. Encourage them to fast. Don't write too many messages. Don't write too many messages. Just write, "Ahi or brothers or sisters, this is the day of Arafah. Please, if you can, fast for Allah." Don't go out and make yourself as a mufti. Because some of the messages that are coming on WhatsApp and Facebook is totally, totally haram. Now listen to this. Somebody is writing and saying, if you circulate this to 100 Muslims, your sins will be forgiven. Who told you that? Check Google. Check WhatsApp now. Check our WhatsApp. So many of those messages. And some of them, they even circulate Christian messages. Oh Lord, we don't have Lord in Islam. Ya Allah. So read these messages clearly and carefully. If you're not sure, send it to someone who is a scholar, and they'll see it and they verify it before you circulate it. Don't just circulate and begin to say, "Oh, if you say astaghfirullah, Allah will quench this dua will quench the wrath and the anger of Allah." Who told you that? Subhanallah. This deen is not any other deen. This deen is not Christianity. I have respect for them. That's their deen. Lakum dinukum wala deen. But this is Islam. This is Islam. You have to be knowledgeable to say. And even with knowledge, it has levels. Don't claim what you don't know. If you don't know, say, "I don't know." If you're not sure of the message, don't circulate it. So you read carefully. Don't go and try to be popular when you're not. This is deen, it's amana. Imam Malik says, "Haza ilmu deenun, wa haza deenu ilmun." Kama qal, he said, this deen is knowledge, or this knowledge is deen. فَانْذُرْ أَمَّنْ تَأْخُذُونَ دِينَكُمْ. Look from who you take your deen. Okay, this is no play, this is no joke. Now what would you do يوم القيامة when you come? يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون. The day when your wealth and your children will not avail you, what would you say? So don't joke with the deen. That's why we don't play with the deen. And so when Christian says, "Oh, you take it seriously," we say, "Yes." I said to them, "We take it very seriously." They say, "Why do you take it seriously?" So because when you say, "We are the children of Allah," we say, "No." They say, "Oh no, you're taking," I say, "The reason why we're taking it seriously," I say, "When you go to the court, the judge is there, the magistrate is there, you're not going to speak nonsense language, right? They want you to be precise. Did you commit the crime? Are you the father of this person?" You don't say, "Oh, I'm the father of all the world." They'll say, "You're mad." Right? So how can you tell me that one person gave birth to all of us? So they say, "Well," I said, "Well, that's it. This is court of law. They deal with straightforward language. We Muslims are the same. Straightforward language. When you do a business, it's straightforward language. Cash, they give you receipt. Pay with your card, they give you receipt. Straightforward. Why do you play games with religion?" So please, my brothers and my sisters, read these WhatsApp messages keenly. For the Yom Arafat, those who get the message, our brothers who go, inshallah, when they tell us, or when we get it from Islam Channel, just circulate a short message. Tomorrow is Yom Arafat, or the day after is Yom Arafat. Please, if you can fast, please fast. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our good deeds. May Allah have mercy upon all our deceased. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us al Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us live as Muslims, and make us grow up as Muslims, and make us die as Muslims. Rabbana dhalamna anfusana wa lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna la nakunanna minal khasirin. Aqim as-salata fa inna as-salata kanat 'ala al-muttaqin.